Hello everyone and welcome back to Engineering Online. In this video, I would be introducing the Proteus 8 professional software. I will explain how to download and install this software and I will explain all of its favorite features and tools. Proteus is by far the most popular electronic design and simulation software. With the help of this software, you can draw electronic circuits and simulate them on your PC. There are several benefits of simulating electronic circuits. Drawing electronic circuits on the computer is quicker than building them in real life. Probability of making mistakes is very low, like loose connections, because in real world it takes hours to find it. Even if components are not available physically, still you can build your circuits and it saves both time and money. There is literally no chance of blowing or breaking up a component. Most expensive components like oscilloscope are easily available inside the simulating environment. And you can pause your simulation and take measurements, which is sometimes not possible in the real world. So, before moving ahead, let's first download and install the Proteus and then we will discover the software in detail. Open google.com and write Proteus 8 Professional Download and then add this keyword get into PC. And then click on the first link that appears. This link will direct you to this website, from where you can download this software for free. If you want to buy this software, then visit their official website. Now click on the download and it will start downloading automatically. It will take some time. Once it is downloaded, check your downloads folder and extract the setup. Now if you look at the setup folder, there are multiple files in it. Open the README document and follow all the steps mentioned in it. As mentioned here, first of all, install Proteus SPO 8.4. Click on the Proteus 8 SPO and the installation is started. Accept the license agreement and make sure that the locally installed license key is selected. Now you have to browse the license key files. Select the same setup folder that is located in the downloads. Open it and install it. And now close it. Now either select the typical option or custom. When you select the custom option, you can install program features of your choice, while in typical, recommended features are installed. An installation is started. Installation is completed now. Close it. Now execute the patch file update Proteus 8.4 SPO demo. Change the destination folder and click on update. Next step is to install the Proteus 8.6 SP2. Click on next and then again next and the installation will begin. It will take some time. Once it is installed, go to your desktop. You will observe here that there are two shortcuts for Proteus. Check the timestamp of both and the one which has older timestamp, delete it and keep the other one. Installation is completed now. Let's explore the software. The home page of this software is divided into several sections. Getting started section is there to provide basic help to start working on the software in the form of documentation. Then there is a dedicated section to guide you about all the tools and features of this software. The About section shows the software version and release information, registration information, customer number, license expiry date, build number, free memory, etc. The News section shows the new releases of this software and allows you to update your software with the new features. Start section allows you to open already saved project, open a new project, either start a new flowchart or open a sample. All the recent projects are also shown here. At the top of the screen, you can see some shortcuts here. You can start a new project, open a saved project, save the current project you are working on, and close the project. This shortcut opens the home page of the software. Since it is a complete design suite, so it has multiple softwares embedded in it, like Schematic Capture, PCB Layout, 3D Visualizer, Gerber View, Design Explorer, Bill of Materials, Source Code, and Project Notes. And this shortcut is for help. So in this video, our main focus would be Schematic Capture. We will discuss other tools in the upcoming parts of this series. So click on this shortcut of Schematic Capture. This dotted area is the largest area of this screen and is known as editing window. It is just like a drawing window where you place components and wire them. This part of the screen is known as overview window and it displays the overview of entire drawing. This part is known as the object selector, and whenever a new component or object is selected, it is shown here. So whenever you want to place a component, click on the P tag and a new window would be opened. It is used to pick devices that you want to add in the schematic. Add the name of the device in the keyword search and all the related components would be shown here. So if you want to categorize the component search, you can select a specific category from here. You also have the option to filter your research and select from the subcategory and specify the manufacturer name also. So when you select your desirable component from the search results, the component can be seen in the right hand side and its PCB preview is also shown here along with the size of the component. Now click on the OK and the component is already added in the object selector pane. Now click on the components and add them in the editing window. Since the components look quite smaller, so I can zoom in so that I can wire them easily. There are four zoom options here. With this you can zoom inside and with this you can zoom out. This shortcut is used to zoom out to view the entire sheet at once, and this is used to zoom into the specific area. Now do the wiring. I need to add the ground here. Right click and go to the place. You will find the ground from the terminal. Now the circuit is complete. If you want to edit the component name, double click at the name and edit it. And if you want to edit the component value, double click the value and edit it. Now let's simulate it. There is a play button down the screen, click on it. And now here the circuit is working. Stop the simulation. There are various other features in the software and we would be exploring them in the upcoming videos of this series. I hope so that this video must have been useful for you. So do share it with your fellows so that they can get benefit from it too. Don't forget to press the like button and subscribe to Engineering Online to stay updated about the new uploads. If you have any suggestions and queries, post your feedback in the comments. You can also connect with us on Facebook and Instagram. Links are provided in the description box. Thank you so much for watching. I will see you next time.